What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and Apple just released iOS 14.2 Gold Master to both registered developers and public beta testers on a Friday, which is extremely rare, but as I said on Twitter yesterday, it was a possibility. And if you're running this beta, you'll know exactly why this update was pushed out as an emergency release today. But if you don't know why, stay tuned. We're going to talk all about iOS 14.2 in this video. So let's go ahead and get right into it. As you can see, the update came in at over 5 gigabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro here, and that size will vary, of course, depending on your device and the version you're coming from. But this was coming from the latest beta, which was beta 4, so a pretty massive update size there. So let's check out the build number for this update. So settings, general, about 14.2. You can see the build number there is 18B91. And if we scroll down a little bit, you can see we have a modem firmware of 2.02.04. So now what's new in iOS 14.2 GM? And let's kick this off with the biggest news surrounding iOS 14.2. And that is the annoying pop-up that you see right here that would appear every single time you unlocked your device on iOS 14.2 beta 4 or beta 3. Any iOS 14.2 beta, you would see this pop up constantly. Even if you went into the notification center and then went out of it, you would see this pop up here that says a new iOS update is now available. Please update from the iOS 14 beta. And then when you went to, you know, the software update section, you would not see any update. And that's because that was a bug. It was extremely annoying. A lot of people downgraded. But again, if you saw my tweet on Twitter yesterday, there was a possibility for Apple to push out a new release for iOS 14.2. And that's exactly what they did. So yes, this new 14.2 beta will fix that annoying pop-up bug. And a lot of people were surprised by this because they haven't seen it before, but that has actually happened before. It happened back in 2018 during the iOS 12 beta stages. And Rambo over on Twitter actually dug into the code to find out the reason that it was happening. And he found that it was because the current build thought it was about to expire. So it would push out, you know, that pop-up saying that a new update is available. So what I think happened here with 14.2 is that Apple may have been running behind and they actually expected another version of 14.2 to be out by, you know, earlier this week. And that's what was causing that pop-up to appear. So pretty interesting, but no more need to get annoyed by it because it has been fixed with this new GM release. Now, as for what's new in this update, there are a lot of things changed and added in this update. As you can see here from the changelog, it is pretty extensive, but of course, like I always do with these GM build videos, I will be covering all of the features more in depth when the 14.2 update gets pushed out to everybody, when it comes out to the public. And of course, in this video, I'm just gonna quickly hit on some of these features and changes in here, because there are also some that were not in, you know, any of the betas, any of the 1 through 4 betas of 14.2. So the first thing I wanna talk about, actually, if you look at the changelog here, is that it says support for iPhone 12 leather sleeve with MagSafe. So that, of course, is Apple's new accessory, and it looks like they added support with that in 14.2. So Apple said that those cases are coming out in November, but now it's looking like they will be coming out in early November. So it's still November, but it looks like they may be coming out maybe with the iPhone 12 Pro Max and the iPhone 12 Mini. So that's good to see support for that on 14.2 as opposed to 14.3, which is also expected in November. Another new feature in 14.2 is optimized battery charging for AirPods. So if we go into Bluetooth here and then go to our AirPods, I have the AirPods Pro for this example, you can see we have optimized battery charging. So a lot of people complain about bad battery life in iOS 14 and just bad battery life after like 2 years of usage. So this should definitely help with that. So below it, you can see it says, to reduce battery aging, iPhone and AirPods learn from your daily charging routine, so AirPods can wait to finish charging past 80% until you need to use them. So that is a great new feature added here in 14.2 that I think a lot of AirPods and AirPods Pro users will appreciate. And then also, if you go to sounds and haptics right here, and then headphone safety, you can see we do also have a new toggle there for headphone notifications. And it says, to protect your hearing, your iPhone will measure headphone audio levels. If you exceed the recommended 7-day limit, a notification is sent and volume is turned down. So that is another great safety feature here for AirPods, AirPods Pro, and any other Bluetooth headphones that you have hooked up to your iPhone. Also, the magnifier application can now detect people and it can tell you how far away they are with people detection. So Apple actually mentions that this is only for the iPhone 12s because it uses the LiDAR sensor. So that is pretty interesting that it can now both detect people and tell how far away they are, which is nice. We also get more than 100 new emoji in iOS 14.2. So a lot of people will be excited about this. You can see we have like the ninja. That's my favorite new emoji right there. We have all kinds of new fruits, new people, new hand gestures, just a lot of new emoji in this update. If you want to see every single emoji that was released, I will leave a link down below that shows every single one of the new emojis in this update. Also, we get 8 new wallpapers. So as you can see right here, this is one of the new wallpapers included with iOS 14.2. And if we go to our settings right here and then go to our wallpapers, so wallpaper right there, choose new wallpaper, and then under stills, you can see we have all these new wallpapers. So right there, so it goes from realistic to a more animated approach right here with these wallpapers, which I actually really like. It's very unlike Apple to do like an animated wallpaper like that, but I'm a big fan of all of the animated wallpapers here in 14.2. I think they look better than the realistic ones that you see right here. And of course, we get a dark mode version for all of these wallpapers as well. As you can see right there, we have like a blue hue to it, a blue tint to the wallpaper, which looks really good in my opinion. I wasn't a fan at first, but it's really grown on me and I really like this wallpaper here. We also get a lot of changes inside of the control center. So first off, in the now playing platter, you could see the now playing screen right there looks completely different than it did in past versions of iOS 14. Then down here, we do also have a redesigned AirPlay menu. So you can see there it shows control other speakers and TVs. If you tap on that, you can see this is what it shows right here. So it looks a lot better in my opinion than it did in 14.1 and previous versions of iOS 14. You also have the AirPlay icon right there. When you tap on that, you can see it shows up just like so. You will also notice that the volume slider there is a little bit bigger as well. The circle right there is a little bit bigger. You also notice that on the lock screen as well. You'll see some minor changes there on the lock screen when you are playing music. We also get intercom support in 14.2 for both the HomePod and the HomePod mini. You can see there inside of the home application, we have intercom. And when you tap on it, you have all your settings here. So it shows, you know, for people. So if I enable myself right there, I can receive notifications when I'm home, anywhere or never. And of course you can have all of your HomeKit enabled devices down here, and it works well with the HomePod, the original HomePod. And of course it will work for the HomePod mini as well. And you can, you know, talk throughout the house with both an Apple Watch or an iPhone or an iPad, whatever you have. So intercom is a really cool new feature. And I will talk more about intercom in depth in my iOS 14.2 review video when it officially releases. And then of course, we do also have the music recognition toggle here inside of the control center via Shazam. So if you tap on that, it will listen for music. And of course, if you are playing music in the background, it will pull up the song and you can, you know, find it on Apple Music or Spotify or whatever. And this is actually really useful. And I really like that it is a control center toggle. And you can see that there is a 10-second timeout. If it finds something or doesn't find something, it will tell you right there. And we also get a lot of fixes for bugs from 14.1 and even some that were occurring in beta 4. So a lot of bugs are fixed here in 14.2. Some of the main ones are the photos widget would just simply not display a photo. So a lot of people reported this to me on 14.2 beta 4, but the photo bug has been fixed. The photo widget bug has been fixed. It will display a photo every time now. Same with the weather widget. So some people reported that the weather widget would actually show the high temperature in Celsius instead of Fahrenheit. So that is fixed as shown in the changelog there from Apple. Also, some people had an issue with the camera when they went to video. It would just show a black screen. It wouldn't actually show anything until you force quit the application and reopened it. But that has been fixed here in 14.2, the GM build, and of course the final release as well. And then of course the keyboard lag has been fixed as well. So a lot of people reported that this was fixed in the beta stages from 14.1. And it looks like, you know, the final release is going to carry over and we will have a fix for the keyboard lag. So if you're having any issues with keyboard, specifically inside of the messages application, you should see a fix in 14.2 GM and at the final release. And of course, like I said earlier, there are some other small changes and features as well. And I will cover those in my 14.2 review video when the official release comes out. And we'll talk about when we can expect that to be released here in a moment. But as far as the performance and battery life, the performance is actually really good. So the animations feel smoother than 14.1 even. And the new music platter is awesome. The new now playing platter is awesome and just really fluid. It just feels solid and it feels like a small bump in performance up from 14.1, which is always welcomed. Now on the iPhone 12 specifically, I did also put 14.2 beta 4 on there and I couldn't really tell a difference in performance or battery life because I guess 14.1 was, you know, shipped on the iPhone 12s. So it was already, you know, really well optimized for it. So it's pretty much, you know, as good as it gets for the time being. So 14.2 didn't really do anything for the 12 series, but for like the iPhone 11 Pro, the iPhone 11s and below, you should see an improvement in performance here. But battery life is about the same on 14.2 as it was on 14.1, which 14.1 was a big improvement over iOS 14 and 14.0.1. Now, also, I do want to mention that Apple One was just released today. So this is Apple's new services bundle. So if we go into our iCloud settings right here and then go to subscriptions, you will see a little section here that says Get Apple One. If you tap on that, you will see all of the bundles right here. So we have the individual, which is $14.95 a month, and that gets you access to Apple Music, Apple TV, Apple Arcade, and 50 gigabytes of iCloud storage for $14.95 a month. Then you have the family, which is the same except for 200 gigabytes versus 50 for $19.95 a month. Then you have the Premier, which saves you $25 a month, and it's $30 a month, and it gives you Apple Music, Apple TV, Apple Arcade, 2 terabytes of iCloud, Apple News Plus, and Apple Fitness Plus, which is coming out soon, but you get all of those for $30 a month, and that saves you $25 a month, because if you did all of them together, you would pay, you know, a lot more. So you do also have a 1 month free trial for all of these plans. So that was just released today as well and should be pretty interesting. So now what's next for Apple? When will we see iOS 14.2, the final release? So let's go into our calendar here, and today is the 30th. So next week is going to be November. It's going to be the start of November. So November 2nd. Now, since we got the GM here on a Friday, I would not expect 14.2 to be released to the public next week. Instead, I would expect Apple to release iOS 14.2 to the public on either November 9th or November 10th. But I think it's going to be November 10th because that is the week that the iPhone 12 Pro Max and the iPhone 12 Mini get released. And this is exactly what Apple did with iOS 14.1. They released it a few days before the iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 Pro were released. So if I had to guess, I would say that iOS 14.2 will likely come out on November 10th. However, there is a very slim possibility of it coming on the week of the 2nd. So anyways, guys, there you have it. That is iOS 14.2, the GM release. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you're a lot less annoyed now that you don't have that annoying pop-up popping up every 2 seconds. So if you guys enjoyed this video, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you guys subscribe so you don't miss when iOS 14.2, the official release, comes out. And of course, there may be a new beta very shortly after that. So stay tuned to the channel. Make sure you guys are subscribed for those videos. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.